Hey guys, welcome back to another YouTube video. It's me, SuperBT2027, and in this video, I'll be showing y'all how to get Insane Assetto Corsa graphics. So first off, you need to go to the Content Manager link, and of course, I'll be putting all the links in the description. So once you get to this link, you're going to want to scroll down to where it says download, and then download directly. So just download it, and then after that, right-click it, show in folder, and then right click again, extract all, then extract. So after that, open up your content manager. And once you get in content manager, it's gonna ask you for your Assetto Corsa main folder. So for me, it's in my D drive, Steam library, Steam apps, common, and then Assetto Corsa, then just select. But it might be different for y'all, so you're going to want to keep track of where your Assetto Corsa folder is. So, after that, go to Settings, Custom Shaders Patch, About and Updates, and then select 1.79, because it's the latest. So, just select that, and I have 1.80, which is the Rain mod, and I'll show y'all how to get that in just a second. So, select this, and then it'll download. But if you want the Rain mod, then you have to go to this link, which is a Patreon, that you'll have to pay, I believe, $5 for to get the Rain. And then after that, you download it, and then just drag it into here on the gray. Then click the three lines, and then you'll see a button that says install. So just click that. Up next is our Sol. So you're gonna wanna go to this link for Sol, and then press the download link, which is right here, and then download it. And after it's done downloading, you're gonna want to right click on it and show in folder, and then go into it and then click on this folder right here. So now we have all the contents of Sol that we need. So you can't just take these and drag it into the content manager, because it'll mess it up and it won't work. You'll just have a black sky. So you need to find your Assetto Corsa folder, which is in my D drive, and then take all of this, take all these folders, but not these, and then just drag it into here. Now, if you already installed Sol before, but you want to install it, then there's a link, or there's a application right here that will uninstall it properly. So just run this if you need to uninstall it, and then you can reinstall it. So once you drag the files in, you'll see this pop up where it says replace, skip, or let me decide. You want to press replace, because it'll put in new files that have exactly what you currently have, and then put in what Sol has. So you want to press replace, but I'm not going to, because I already have Sol. So after you install Sol, next is reshade. Oh, also, there's a different version of Sol called Pure, which is this link right here, which I think you can pay as little as $1 for. After that, you just go, you'll have to find the link to download it, but after that, it's pretty much the same process to install the regular Sol. So if you want Pure, then you can get it, but it's not necessary, because all it does is add special textures for like every map and every car, and it's constantly being updated. So yeah. After that, then we have reshade. So you're gonna want to press download, which is press that button at the top, download, and then download 5.7.0, which is the button on the top. So download that and then double click it to run it. And you're gonna want to look for the application that says acs.exe. Not this one, not this one, and not this one, but this one. So press next, and then select DirectX 10, 11, 12, next. And then for me, I'm gonna uninstall because I have 5.6. So that's that. And I'm gonna open it back up, acs.exe. And then press next, and then uncheck all, and then check all to make sure you get all of the graphics you want. So press next after that, and it'll download. And now it's finished. So now we have Reshade. So after you install everything, you want to go back into Content Manager, Settings, Weather FX, and then select Sol 2.4. And then if you have Pure, then select Pure. But I have an old version of Pure, so it won't work. So I just have Sol at the moment. And then reset, and it'll load. So now to get tracks and cars, I'm going to show you guys how to do that. So let's say we want drift tracks. Let's look up Seto Corsa drift. So there's also a Seto Corsa club, which is really good. There's drift cars. I'm gonna go with drift cars for now. Maybe not. Filters. Let's get this Nissan S15. I'm gonna download that. Maybe not. Man. I don't know why, but it's kind of hard to get mods now. Okay, what about this car? This car work? It will work. Alright. So we have a Mitsubishi now. And I'm just going to cancel this because it's going too slow. Now I want to get tracks. Let's go ahead and get this track for our Mitsubishi. Because it's like a rally car. This is a rally track. So I'm going to go ahead and click download as well. Download on race department. Nope. Never mind. Race department is slow. I don't know why. Okay. What else is there? Well, let's get rally filters. This track looks good. Alright, so download. Now it's downloading. So once you have your tracks or cars, whatever mod you got, you're just going to want to drag it in here into Content Manager and drag it all in. So after that, you press install. And install. And it's all in there. So I'm gonna show you guys a little bit of gameplay. Alright guys, so once you get in, it should be really bright, and you're gonna wanna press this button here to start it up. And as you can see, sky looks good, and it's bright, and the shadows. Yeah, so here's gameplay footage.
Mm-hmm.
that's enough gameplay footage for y'all. Hope y'all enjoyed this tutorial and gameplay, and peace.